Hi everyone, Kristina here. Today is my very first ever mail call video, and this is mail call for September 2013. These are cards that I've received over the last month or so with the theme of autumn or Halloween. In total, I received 56 different packages in the mail. Some had more than one envelope, so the card count is a slightly more than 56, but I'm still completely overwhelmed with the response, you guys. Actually, it's no surprise that I received so many cards because I know you love card making. I'm gonna go through and show you some of the ones that really caught my eye when I was opening all of the envelopes, and I'm gonna share with you a little bit why that caught my eye as I show you each one. And I know there are a lot that are not shown, and I feel so bad. I'm so sorry I can't show all of them. I really wanted to show all of them, but there's just not the time in one of these videos. So if you sent me a card, I totally appreciate it. Thank you so much for sending me a card or a little something in the mail. I really appreciate you. And hopefully next time when you send a card, I'll be able to show it in a future video. So if you guys want to take part in another one of these mail calls, the theme for October is, let's see, it is gratitude and Thanksgiving, or thanks, any type of thank you card. And you can send any of your cards to me at the address that's below in the video description, or over at my blog I'll have my address posted with this video as well. And you have until Halloween, until October 31st, to send me those cards. So I hope you guys participate and send in those cards. I love seeing what you guys are up to. And let's jump right into the cards, and I'll start showing you what you guys have sent me over the last 30 days.
Okay, these are in no specific order. I'm just going to take them out of the box. And this first one is from Angel. And I thought this little die-cut squirrel was so super cute with a little sentiment, and that's about you. She sent an envelope as well for me to send this to Operation Right Home. And she was so sweet. She actually printed out the Operation Right Home calendar for me. So I realized before I said that I would send them to Operation Right Home, the ones that were blank, I knew that I would miss the deadline. But so this will help while I plan some later mail calls. Next up is from one of my friends, Heather. I've actually met her in person a couple times. She's a sweetheart, and she sent a little flip card for Happy Halloween. I loved the bright, fun colors, and I just love the simple design, letting those bright colors really shine. All right, here is one. I wanted to show you guys this little stamp down here. I actually Instagrammed this. If you want to follow me on Instagram, my name on Instagram is Star of May. I just thought it was so cute. Encloses a handmade card. As such, it deserves a place of honor and respect in your home and should not be casually discarded like an ordinary store-bought card. I just thought that was really funny. And inside, she actually sent me this cute card here. Adorable. These little die-cut little animals. I kind of wanted to show these to you guys up front because I thought they were so cute. And inside there's a sentiment. This card is from Melinda. I really loved her use of the sticky tape with glitter on top and how she made her own little candy corn. I thought it was super, super cute. This card is from Charlotte. And watch this as I pull this apart. Out pops a little sentiment. It's a so cute little pop-up card. And I actually looked inside to kind of try to figure out how it was done. And it looks like it's a specific fold on the inside. I thought it was just really fun. And she colored in the image on the front as well. All right, this one is from Jessica. And I had to show you guys the fun envelope. She used a broad edge calligraphy marker for my address. And then on the other side of the envelope, she stamped this really pretty tree stamp, which she used on her card. So pretty. I love that she, I'm assuming she inked with a marker all the separate little leaves and then with the branches in brown. Super, super cute. She wrote me a little message inside. And then that little bird. Okay, I was blown away by this card. It's so pretty. In fact, it could go either way. I'm not really sure which way. I think it'd be really pretty this direction, or it'd be really pretty this one. This is from Nancy, and she mentions that she used the Tim Holtz tattered leaves, and she colored them with distress markers and water. So, so super pretty. Look at all that detail. Okay, next I have this card from Steffi. I think it's Steffi. Yeah, Steffi from Germany. I thought it was really creative the way she used this little stamp and made it look like a crowd, like little zombies or something like that. And then she made me this really cute little pouch. She sewed it herself and embroidered, put trick or treat on the back, and she put some baker's twine on the zipper. And then inside it has stars. I thought that was so, so, so cute. Now, you guys don't need to send me gifts, but I totally appreciate this pouch. I have tons and tons of little pouches like this for when I travel. So this is perfect. This is a really pretty card sent to me from Jen in Canada, and her daughter Braylin wanted to send these cards along as well. Thought this was really pretty, the white embossing, and it looks like distress ink back here. And then this really pretty knot tied really well, and it traveled through the mail really well too. I mean, it's really flat. So that's some really good ribbon right there. This card right here is from Tessa, and she lives in Canada, and she's 15 years old. I think it's amazing. I love seeing what younger crafters are doing. I thought it was really cute coloring and the sentiment. Happy fall from one nut to another. I think it's so cute. Okay, this is from Jamila, and I hope I said her name right. One of the ghosts fell off in the package, so I hope I put it back in the right spot, but... I thought this was just so creative. It has twigs on it, and she die cut some leaves and put the leaves on the end of the twigs. And I just thought it was a super creative three-dimensional card. Okay, this is from Susan, and I love that she made this into a shaker card. All those pieces move around inside. And she even made an envelope for the card as well. Okay, I had to show you guys these cards from Anita. Look at this cute card. Pulls out and there's a little mummy inside. Hello, adorable. She said that she loves to make interactive cards, so that's what she sent. And then she has these little chocolate things. So cute. And then here's one with some pumpkins. And it like pulls out the chocolate. It looks like the little ghost guy or whatever is holding the chocolate. So cute. Thank you, Anita. Adorable. Okay, here is a really cute card from Christopher. He's in high school, another really young crafter. Thought this was a really, really cute card. And he also did an envelope, stamped envelope with a bunch of Halloween stamps. Thought it was such a fun idea. Looks like he used those stamps, you know, the ones that are here at this boo or whatever. He made an embossed background over here. Thought it was really, really fun. Here is a card and envelope from Carolina. I think her coloring right here is fantastic with the shading on top of the pumpkins. And then these little tiny sequins in the corner. I think it's the perfect touch. Okay, this is from Kathy. She sent me a couple cards and this was my favorite. I love how she used this vellum on top. It's actually a whole vellum sheet. And she adhered it just onto the back of the card. There's just a strip of adhesive up at the top. I just thought it was super cute. There's the card, and she put that big background back there. I think that's a great use of vellum on your card. This is a card and envelope set from Pat. Thought it was a really cute use of Tim Holtz's sketchy leaf stamp, and then the little sentiment inside. Really cute, and then she made an envelope using some pattern paper. And she did something that you guys are more than welcome to do. She sent a self-addressed stamped envelope for me to send the cards back to her, you know, if I show them on camera or whatever. So if you guys want to do that for your future mail calls, feel free. You can send me a self-addressed envelope and I'll mail you your cards back to you. Here is a really fun card from Ginger. I like this card specifically because it doesn't scream autumn, but it has some autumn colors and some sunflowers. And I love that she stamped this and then ran it through an embossing folder. So you get a little bit of that texture plus the stamping. And I really love this color of enamel dot down here. Such a really cute card. This is a card from a fellow Kristina, spelled the exact same way. She's from Greece. And I just really loved the little fox that she drew down here. And well, maybe it's a stamp. I don't know. It looks like she may have drawn it. I think it's just so cute. And inside, there's a little spot where the fox is all curled up sleeping. I thought it was just adorable. Here's a card from Suzanne, a sparkly spider. That spider is, seriously, if I saw a spider that was that size, oh, heebie-jeebie. No, 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 no spider that large. I think this is just a really well-made card, balanced really well, and I love that there's just the pop of orange right across the center. Here is a card from Cheryl. I hope I'm saying that right. And I just thought this was another fun way of using vellum. She put vellum on top of a pattern paper, right on top, kind of toned it down a little bit so that she could do some embossing. And in the card, she told me that she used some creative ways to cover up some mistakes, but I don't know where these mistakes are. So good job. It looks fantastic. This super adorable card is from Julia in Germany. And she, it looks like she created this bat herself and punched out some shapes. Super creative. And I love that she used, I think it's a graphite pencil or maybe it was a silver pen to draw in the rest of the face. I thought that was super, super cute. And she also has glitter all around the outside edges. Just a really fun way of making a card. And it's not your standard card size either. It is 4 1/4 tall by about 7 1/2 wide. So it's an unusual size, but I really, really love that she included all those different colors. And I also want to take a note that if you're working on a animal or a shape or something that's mostly black and you need to differentiate between the two shapes, go ahead and use a gray. She used black and then also a gray. We're nearing the end here, and I wanted to show you this really fun envelope from Sharon. She created this fun kind of leaf-shaped flap. And then inside, she has a little autumn card. I just thought that was a super creative way of creating your own envelope. And I love that it has this whole circular cutout. I just thought that was really, really fun. Okay, and I wanted to show you guys a couple really fun cards that had Manny on them, or Manny. All right, so here's a card that Cheryl, who made this card, she sent this one separately for Manny with a cute little cat. I'm hoping that Manny got better. This was after he had his teeth pulled. And I'm not sure who sent this one. In fact, they, you know, in the return address, they just put Manny. I thought that was super cute. And the person drew Manny on top of some pumpkins. So cute. And it really does look like Manny. He's got the little, he even has the little white patch on the back of his, you know, on his back and the black tail. Happy fall. And then inside it has all these stamps. And then it says, I love you, love Manny. So cute. I thought it was just adorable. So that is mail call for September 2013. Once again, if you want to participate for October, go ahead and send me your gratitude or Thanksgiving cards to the address down in the YouTube description area, or it's over at my blog as well. And thanks for watching. Before the video ends, I have 3 more videos for you to check out, and they are all my most 3 recent videos. The first one is yesterday's Make a Card Monday, the one in the middle is last week's Friday Focus, and the very last one on the right is last week's Color Wednesday. So I hope you guys enjoy those videos. If you want to see more videos like this, more mail call videos, more card making videos, things like that, go ahead and hit that subscribe button in the top corner. You can visit my blog at kwernerdesign.com, and you can follow me at Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Pinterest. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I will catch you guys tomorrow for another video.